Hello guys, this is Howard Noor from Pakivix, and I'm here with the lecture series on M1 Module 1 Mathematics. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to continue the lecture series. I have only uploaded lecture 1 of Mathematics, but from now onwards I will complete the whole Mathematics course for Easa Parts Physics B1 examinations. If you like my video, please like, please then comment and share, and also subscribe my channel to watch more videos. Okay, so let's continue with the training. In previous lectures we have studied about addition and I told you about subtraction, multiplication and division. In this lecture we are going to study about significant numbers and decimal numbers. So let's start with significant numbers. Alright, consider a person who has a bank balance of 12 million and something pounds. Apart from being rich, it would generally be stated that he has 12.6 million pounds. Okay, that's not to say that he is not bothered about the rest, but that for most purposes this would be good enough. What we have done is express the number to three significant figures. Okay, the first or most significant figure is the 1, the second is the 2, and the third is the 6. So it is stated as 12.6 million pounds. Let's now consider the same number, but this time we wish to express it to only two significant figures. At first, it would appear that it should be 12 million pounds. However, as 12.6 million pounds is closer to 13 million pounds, it is more accurate to declare it as such. Therefore, the number is 13 million pounds, correct to two significant figures. Alright, so let us now consider the example. Consider the number 378 and we have to define it to two significant figures. So 370 is the lowest it could be and 380 is the highest it could be, but as 378 closer to 380 then 370, then 378 equals 380, correct to two significant figures. Alright, so now let's move on decimal numbers. These are very similar to significant numbers, but instead of starting at the most significant number, we start at the decimal point. Okay, now let us go to the example. Consider the number 31.678 and define it to two decimal places. Well, the 6 is the first number of this decimal point, so it's occupying the first decimal place. By definition, the 7 is occupying the second decimal place. Finally, the 8 is occupying the third decimal place. So, taking into account the second decimal place, then this is 0.67. But as the next number is greater than 4, then we should round up to 0.68. Consequently, 31.678 is equal to 31.68, corrected to two decimal places. Now move on to second example. Consider the number 342.000945 and we should define it to three decimal places. Well, the third zero is occupying the third decimal place, and as the next number is greater than 4, then we should round up. Consequently, 342.000945 is 342.001, corrected to three decimal places. So the exercise for you guys will be given in the description. Alright guys, that's all for today. Thanks for watching my video. If you have any queries, please feel free to ask in comment box, and also subscribe my channel to learn more about this modular training examination. Alright guys, have a nice day. Bye bye.